Hear us.
Good morning. Thanks for having me. After the phone trouble I had last time, I was afraid you'd never have me back on.
No, it was you personally is why we don't want to have you on. Had nothing to do with the phone problems. Can you guarantee that all the polling places are going to be open on time tomorrow?
I can guarantee that we've been working with the local election authorities to make sure that everything runs smoothly. And if there are any hiccups, we'll be on it very quickly, with people ready to go wherever they're needed around the state.
All right. Lots of confusion, ins and outs, ups and downs, courtrooms, law cases, judges' rulings. Do I need a valid picture ID to vote tomorrow?
You do not, as we've been saying since the beginning. If you're a registered voter, you'll be able to vote. If you have that government-issued photo ID, like your driver's license, it'll make it a little bit faster and easier because they can just scan the UPC code on the back of it. But if you don't have that government-issued photo ID, if you just have that card that was sent to you from your election authority, you have that bank statement, you have that utility bill, you may use those. And frankly, if you have the shirt on the back, the pants on your legs, and shoes so we don't get in trouble with the health department, as long as you're registered, you will still be able to vote.
What are your numbers telling you about percentage of people who are going to come out and vote?
We've worked with the local election authorities to come up with, they were estimating the low 50%, but that was a couple weeks ago. I think that we're seeing some revisions upward. I'm hoping that we're in the upper 50s, maybe even breaking 60%, which would give us the best turnout in about 20 years.
You are now better than 2 years ago turnout?
Well, for midterm elections.
Okay, midterm elections. Okay.
Not for a presidential. You know, if we get, you know, upper 60s, we could do that, but that'd be great, but I don't know that we can do that.
What are you looking for tomorrow? What do you want to see tomorrow, and or what do you want us to know?
I want to see good turnout. I want to see the polls open on time, as you mentioned, and I'm praying for large margins so there are no recounts.
What are the rules on a recount, or do you not even want to go down that path?
Well, technically, if the margins are close enough, it depends on the race what the margin has to be. The candidate may request a recount, but hopefully that's all just... we don't need to deal with that tomorrow.
Yeah. It's a very long ballot. How worried are you about long lines?
Very worried. One of the things that we've been trying to do is trying to get the message out to voters to educate themselves. Watching campaign commercials generally doesn't do it, but get them to educate themselves about what's going to be on the ballot. They can go to govotemissouri.com to read the full language of all the statewide issues that are going to be on their ballot. If there are local issues, they can reach out to their local election authority. One of the things that we've suggested is for voters to reach out to the local election authority to get a sample ballot. If you get that sample ballot and you want, you can go ahead and fill out who you want to vote for and how you want to vote on that sample ballot. You can take that with you to the polling places and then use that to quickly go through the process. I think St. Louis County has the longest ballots they've ever had. They're double-sided and I think maybe 19 inches long, so it will take a while to go through it all. Educate yourself before you go to the polls.
If you are standing in line at 7 o'clock tomorrow night, will you be allowed to vote?
Yes. As long as you are in line at 7 o'clock, you have the right to vote. At 7 o'clock across the state, at our polls, poll workers will come out to see where the line is. They will mark the end of the line, and everyone that's in line at 7 o'clock, as long as they're registered, they get to vote.
All right. That is good to know. There was one other question I had for you. Just in terms of the length of ballot, do you ever see a time where there might be two pages on a ballot? I mean, it's front and back, right? And some people forget to fill out the back. But, I mean, these are getting pretty long. A piece of paper can only be so long.
We may get to that point at some place, but it is much easier for the provision of elections to have just one piece of paper that people have to deal with. We'll have to look at it. It's, you know, the overabundance of ballot issues is what's making the ballot so long.
Jay Ashcroft, the Secretary of State in terms in charge of ballots. Whoever fixed your phone, give him a raise. Perfect job.
I will. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Have a good day. Jay Ashcroft, Missouri Secretary of State. Tomorrow's